in this video, we're gonna go over my final review of the Samsung S10e, and this is about 9 months of experience. And I'm saying this is my final review because I'm planning to trade this in to get the new Samsung S20. So if you guys are new to this channel, please subscribe and you'll see more content of the S20 in the future. All right, so moving on to my 9 month review, the biggest difference between this video and my 1 month video is basically the new One UI 2.0. I feel like with this new UI, they made a lot of little detailed fixes that just makes the whole experience really polished. And one of the biggest experience that I really like enjoy using right now is the going back gesture. And you guys know that I really love using this ever since the Huawei Mate 20. And back then for me, it was a really big game changer. Now that I'm using it on the Oppo, the Pixel, and a little bit on the iPhone on certain apps, now that I can finally use it on the Samsung, it's like going to each phone really makes it more seamless for me. I don't really have to like think about what gesture I use for each phone. So for me, I really enjoy using that the most. And with a person with smaller hands, it is a burden just to reach to the bottom corner just to go back. And since my thumb is basically sitting right next to the edge of the screen anyways, I can easily swipe back with little to no effort. Let's move on to the side fingerprint sensor. And for now, I would say it's easier for me to reach. I've gotten used to it, but what made it easier for me is basically having a case on it. And I will say thicker the case the better because I can actually feel for the cutout and easily get into my phone without a problem. And for face detection, they actually added the option to use your eyes, which is a really good thing. And for the overall experience of that is really good. When there's light, you can easily get into your phone. But when I'm about to fall asleep, all the lights are off and it's just me and the phone, I would say that face detection right there at that time, it's gonna struggle a bit. Most of the time, it doesn't even get me in. So if you are using this in a lot of dark situations, you might have some trouble getting into your phone with just face detection. Now for the camera, after comparing to so many other phones this year, I would say Samsung cameras are basically really well-rounded, the most well-rounded in terms of video quality and picture quality in one single phone. So a lot of other phones are really good at one thing or the other. I would say Samsung will give you the best package overall. The colors coming out of the camera is really boosted and saturated. So if you really like those vibrant colors that really make your pictures pop, then I would say the Samsung is the way to go. And with this new updated UI 2.0, the whole camera UI is so much more cleaner. I really love it because one of the best things is that I can actually use or move around the camera modes that I only use right on the main screen and just toss out or just move away all the ones I don't use. You guys may know that Samsung has one of the widest ultra wide angle lenses out there. And after comparing this phone to other phones, I will say that their ultra wide angle pictures kind of give a bit more oomph and epicness to it, especially if you're taking pictures of buildings, monuments, and just statues. It really kind of gives you that like extra landscapey feel. So if you love ultra wide angle lenses, I would say that Samsung is one of the biggest or best ones out there. Now moving on to battery life, if you see my 1 month review, I said that it wasn't really that good. Till this day, it's still not that good. Personally, I don't like leaving my phones charging overnight, so when I wake up, I still tend to lose about 7% and even sometimes 11% overnight. With other phones, it tend to be about 2-5%, so honestly, I would rather start my day off with 95% than 89%. And some of you guys said to bring a battery bank, which I do when I have my bag on and such. If I'm going to a cafe and get some work done, then yes, I'll have it. But if I'm going out with my friends to like a party, a restaurant, a bar, or even like a formal occasion, I want to be as minimal as possible. I don't want to bring anything extra but my wallet, keys, and phone. And during nighttime when I'm at a dinner or something, looking at my phone, seeing that it's at 35%, just sitting there realizing that, damn, I really could need that extra 5% I lost overnight. That could be really important at the end of that day. But as a casual user, it gets me throughout the day just fine for the most part. Let's say I'm just waiting at an appointment and I just started playing a lot of games and watching a lot of videos, then most likely I would have to charge it before my day ends. So basically for all those heavy smartphone users out there, the battery on a Samsung S10e will probably not meet your standards. One last con for me is on the personal side, I use Google Everything, so I just find it more streamlined and much more easier to use within my workflow. So after using the Samsung phone, I realized that there's a lot of Samsung bloatware that I don't use or I don't need. And basically I would have to sign up for a Samsung account just to get the most benefits out of the phone. And there's a lot of things that I don't really get, like the extra Galaxy Play Store, which the Google Play Store already have. So it's like a lot of redundant stuff that I don't really see the need of. And it kind of just takes up some space on my phone. And I would rather use that space on all my photos and videos than on apps that I don't really use. But if you are deep into their ecosystem, then I would say you would take a lot of benefits to it because you're using it. So overall, the Samsung S10e is a really good phone. The size is perfect for people with smaller hands, and it's just really comfortable to use. If you really like having customizations, a lot of options, then Samsung is basically one of the best phones to have. And with this new UI, I would say the whole experience is even cleaner. For the camera quality, it is really well-rounded. From photos to video, I would say the whole overall package is really consistent and really good quality. For the fingerprint sensor, it works really fast and flawlessly. For me, I'm more of a fan when it's placed on the back of the phone, because I can easily get into the phone with my left or right hand. I do find situations that there are times when my right hand is busy and I'm holding it with my left hand and I would have to reach around just to get into the fingerprint with my index finger. And if Samsung can fix the battery management on the S10e, then I will say this phone will be on point, especially with their new updated UI. Everything seems to be much more cleaner, so the overall user experience has really gotten better. I do have links down below if you guys are interested checking this phone out. Please follow me on Instagram, give a like, subscribe. Thanks for watching, and I will see you guys later.